Professor Asare-Bediako calls for stronger decentralization and integrated planning at Ghana Institute of Planning Conference. Speaking at the 53rd annual conference and meeting of the Ghana Institute of Planning in Sunyani, Professor Asare-Bediako, Vice Chancellor of the University of Energy and Natural Resources, underscored the critical need to strengthen decentralization and integrated planning to advance Ghana's sustainable development goals. In his address, Professor Bediako highlighted the progress made in fostering grassroots participation and implementing tailored solutions for communities. However, he noted significant challenges that continue to hinder the full realization of decentralization's potential. He referred to these challenges as nests under a storm and called for deliberate measures to address them. Professor Bediako identified four major obstacles to effective decentralization and planning. One, fragmented planning structures. 2, resource constraints. 3, capacity deficits within local governments. 4, limited citizen engagement in planning processes. The Vice Chancellor proposed a series of actionable measures: capacity building for local governments, strengthening metropolitan, municipal, and district assemblies, MMDAs, to independently fund and implement governance plans, equipping local government officials with advanced training and exposure to international best practices, enhancing data systems, developing robust data systems to support evidence-based decision-making and integrated planning. Community engagement. Actively involving citizens in planning processes to ensure solutions are inclusive and people-centered. Leveraging technology. Deploying digital tools to streamline planning processes, improve monitoring, and enhance accountability in implementation. Professor Bediako emphasized a vision of Ghana as a resilient, equitable, and sustainable society where no one is left behind. He described integrated planning and decentralized development not only as tools, but as symbols of Ghana's determination to tackle its developmental challenges. Commending the Ghana Institute of Planning for providing a platform for meaningful dialogue, Professor Bediako urged stakeholders to collaborate in turning discussions into actionable policies. He called for collective effort in overcoming obstacles, capitalizing on opportunities, and shaping a future that meets the aspirations of all Ghanaians. Closing his address on a hopeful note, Professor Bediako encouraged participants to engage in fruitful deliberations and contribute solutions that will propel Ghana toward a brighter, more sustainable future. This year's conference provided a critical space for stakeholders to discuss and strategize around Ghana's most pressing planning and decentralization challenges, setting the stage for innovative approaches to national development.
We have created opportunities for grassroots participation and tailored solutions to community-specific challenges. Yet, the nexus between decentralization and planning remain underexplored. To fully realize decentralization potential, we must strengthen the capacity of local government to undertake integrated planning. We must ensure that the metropolitan, municipal, and district assemblies have the tools, funding, and autonomy to implement plans effectively while being held accountable. While the prospects are promising, we cannot overlook the challenges, such as the fragmented planning structures, resource constraints, capacity deficits, policy misalignment. And to address these challenges, we propose the following. We are to enhance the data system and build capacity that strengthens the skills of planners and local government officials through training and exposure to best practices and leveraging technology, harmonizing policies, community engagement by engaging citizens in the planning process to ensure that solutions are people-centered and context-specific. Then leveraging technology by using digital tools to streamline processes, improve monitoring, and enhance accountability in planning execution. As we deliberate on these critical teams, let us remind ourselves of the shared vision we have for Ghana, a resilient, equitable, and sustainable society where no one is left behind. Integrated planning and decentralized development are not just tools, but enablers of this vision. I commend the Ghana Institute of Planners for providing this platform for dialogue and help all stakeholders to translate our discussion into actionable policies and strategies. Together, we can overcome the challenges, seize the opportunities, and create future that fulfills the aspiration of every Ghanaian. May our deliberations bring fruitful solutions to our challenges. As a nation, and may we be better off at the end of the day. Thank you.